VH1 recently did a profile on a gay Mormon man who has decided to live his life as a straight guy. Now, he's out of the closet, his wife knows he's gay, he completely admits that he's attracted to men as opposed to women, but he says that he lives this way happily and that he's not trying to force other people to live their lives the way he is. Now, let's watch the video quickly and then I'll give you some of his quotes.
Can you finish your Valentine's before you get dressed?
Okay.
Because your party's today, huh?
I genuinely love my wife.
And I love you too. And I got lip gloss on you.
You're that funny face again.
We're your typical Mormon family. We have three beautiful daughters. Anna is 6, Viva is 4, and Tessa is 2. The Mormon faith is such a huge part of who we are.
We're ready to go for prayer. Okay. Whose turn is it?
Mormonism is incredibly important as a part of my life.
They say, Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for our family. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen. Good job, T.
So the one thing that makes our marriage different than most is the fact that I am homosexual.
Yep.
But I've chosen to marry Lolly because I love her very much.
Wow.
It's an interesting story to say the least, but he says, you know, if you're gay, I mean, there are pros and cons to living your life in either way. So he really wanted to have children. He really wanted to stay true to his religion, which is part of the reason why he made this decision to marry a woman. And I just to give you some more context into what he's going through, I just find this entire case really interesting. They ask him, you know, how do you feel when you walk into a room of naked people, naked men and naked women? What are you attracted to? He says the following: I've never found a question that cuts to the heart of the matter more effectively. So if everyone in this room took off their clothes, would you be turned on by the girls or the guys? My answer, which I didn't say out loud, was unquestionably the guys, and it was unquestionably not the girls. And that still is my answer. It's really not very complicated. Yes, it is.
He was asked that actually in junior high school, mm-hmm. when he's recounting that to say that it's still the it's still the case, because he's been, well, obviously he's been gay since he became a sexual aware sexual being, right?
Yeah, 11 or 12 he realized that he was gay, and he was like, wait, why aren't I finding myself attracted to girls? What's going on?
Okay, so I'm incredibly conflicted by this. First, I think it's an awesome piece of propaganda in some ways, because it's basically saying, no, Mormon church cures everything, right? Don't worry about being gay, just
be Mormon.
Be Mormon and go and become married and have this awesome, lovely life, because his life looks great in that video.
And included in that awesome, lovely life is what he describes as an active, robust sex life with his wife.
Yes.
That's interesting. So now, the second part, though, is that I love his honesty, right? It's so the thing that I can't stand is when the Marcus Bachmans of the world are like, what do you mean? What? I'm totally straight, right? And but, you know, like, maybe we're being a little unfair to Marcus Bachman, but Larry Craig, I'm not gay, nor have I ever been gay, except for all the times in the male bathroom in Union Station and all the airports across the country. Now, he's not saying that. He's like, I am gay, but I chose to do this. And then at that point, do you have to respect his decision and say, okay, that's what he chose to do?
Well, I think you have to respect the decision that a grown-up makes about how to lead his own life.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And he's not trying to convert other people. He was very careful. In fact, he urges in the blog post that he wrote, that Gawker ran, that he doesn't, he says, if you...
Yeah, have those quotes, because I think they were very powerful quotes. But before we get to that one, I actually want to mention what you said about his sex life. So, you know, it's, how do you have sex with someone that you're not attracted to? And he kind of clarifies that for the readers. He says, I won't get into boring details of the research here, but basically when sex is done right, at its deepest level, it's about intimacy. The circumstances of our marriage allowed us to build a sexual relationship that is based on everything partners should want in their sex life. Intimacy, communication, genuine love and affection. This has resulted in us having a better sex life than most people I personally know, most of whom are straight. Go fig.
Okay, two things about that. Number one, in other words, I close my eyes and think of Bob.
I know, okay. I felt so sad when I read that. And I know that he doesn't mean it that way, but you want to be attracted to your partner. You want the lust. And I know that lust fades in a marriage regardless of whether or not you're attracted to the person. But still, like, to as a woman, to know that my husband never really found me attractive and kind of forced himself to be with me because he wanted kids and he wanted to stay true to his religion, I would hate feeling that way. And I'm not judging his wife. That was her decision. And, you know, they're not trying to convert people. And I love that.
And how do you know she's not closing her eyes and thinking about Bob, too? Right?
Well, she
and so
is.
She probably is. But if they're talking about it and they're honest about it and they're communicating and they have a sex life that works for them, who are we to judge?
So the good part is that they've found a bond and they're connected to each other and they love each other and they clearly love their kids and their kids are as happily as an overwhelmingly oppressively religious home can be, seem incredibly happy. But there are, well, I don't know exactly what Anna has here, so I'll wait, but let me see what else.
In terms of, this being used as propaganda, they had to say the following. I want to make it very clear that while I have found a path that brings me profound joy and that is the right path for me, I don't endorse this as the only path for somebody who is gay and religious. I will never, ever judge somebody else's path as being incorrect, and I know many people who have chosen different paths than myself. If you know and love somebody who is gay and LDS or Christian, your job is to love and nothing more. Let go of your impulse to correct them or control them or propel them down the path you think is right for them. Do what you need to do to move past that impulse. Do not condemn the choices your loved ones make.
So there's no question, you gotta give him credit for that.
No, look, he's a good guy. The only debate I think I'm having internally in my head is whether any of it is wrong. Like, I think he's largely right. Like, that's the decision he wanted to make. He wanted to have kids. He's got three beautiful kids. You know, he believes his religion. It's not my cup of tea, but he cares about it deeply. I'm sure he does love his wife, you know, and she might be his best friend in some ways,
but
right?
But he's not asking very important, critical questions that anybody who's emotionally honest or intellectually honest asks. And so I don't believe this guy. I want him to be happy, and I want his family to be happy. I hope that goes without saying. And I love that he made a point to say, don't try and change anybody. Mm-hmm. That this is his decision. He talked about the Mormon Church. The doctrine of the Mormon Church is true. One of the key doctrines is that marriage between a man and woman is ordained of God and that the family is central to the Creator's plan for the eternal destiny of his children. You know, like, shut up. Like, that's all.
We got no use for that, but we're not Mormons, so.
I got it said, but what he's done here is saying, look, if you're trapped in this religious theocracy, then deny who you are. Part of it is he has found one of six women in the country, God bless him, who will be like, yeah, I'll marry a gay guy, because he's my friend. But that is not what 99.9% of the people in the world are looking for.
And by the way, you could also have a family while you're gay. You can adopt kids.
Yeah, you can adopt kids while you're gay. And again, and so in that sense, it also, remember, the doctrine he's citing is a doctrine that is bigoted against gay people.
Yeah, and that's the most important part. And that's the thing we can't ever get really quite beyond. Because on the one hand, they say, respect my religious beliefs. On the other hand, they don't respect gay people's identity and how they want to live their life.
And also keep in mind that he's putting himself in a really difficult situation because the Mormon Church still rejects him and gay people reject him.
I bet that if you ask his pastor and maybe even the Mormon Church, they say as long as you're not having gay sex,
as long as you're
terrific.
Yeah, there are members of the Mormon Church that are supportive of him that will tell him, look, being gay is not a sin in and of itself. Gay acts are the sins,
in
right?
In fact, that's why I think this video is propaganda because they're making it seem like even if you're gay, it's okay. You can make the choice to live a straight life. Right, and if you don't, well, then it's your fault.
But he still deals with criticism within the church, members that are like, you're gay. So regardless of
there's that too.
Right, so there's the dumber gay people and there's the dumber Mormons in this case around him. And then there's the slightly less dumb ones who say it's okay to be gay, but you can't act on it. That's the same sort of hideous, hateful, oppressive ideology that has torturing thousands and hundreds of thousands of gay kids across this country because their thought is, yeah, it's fine to be gay. Just don't act on your most primal sexual need, which is insane. And then the other thing that I can't bear about this guy and this idea is that he mentions here, he says, we have several reasons for opening up about this part of our lives. First and foremost, my clinical work as a therapist is taking me in the direction of helping clients who struggle to reconcile their sexual orientation with their religious beliefs.
Oh, over. I got you.
Not a therapist. Yeah. Get out. Don't see this guy. Unqualified. He's a dangerous, dangerous, dangerous guy. No one should go see this guy for help. You want to live your life this way? Do not talk to other people about making this choice. Ever. Ever, ever, ever.
I mean, he doesn't seem like he's trying to force people or convince people to live their lives the way
he is. In this wonderful piece of propaganda tape. He seems like the loveliest guy on earth.
Yeah.
Now, look. Here's the thing. Ben swung me on it based on that. And it's funny to call him a dangerous guy because he looks like the least dangerous man in America.
As a therapist.
Okay. But so my conclusion on this is that, look, if we're just looking at him in a bubble, just him, right?
Fine.
And the reality is he's probably bisexual, right?
He says no.
Okay, he says no, but I mean, my guess is on the spectrum, it's not a black and white issue, on the spectrum he's probably 20% straight and 80% gay. I mean, at least he can soldier on in a straight
marriage. With this one woman who he's clearly very, very close to.
Right, et cetera. So, and I wouldn't judge him and I'd say, God bless your life.
Totally.
Okay. But within the context, as Ben is pointing out, of the larger thing, the whole point of this tape is to say, if you're gay, it is a choice. Look at this guy. See, he made the choice to act straight even though he feels gay. So you can do the same thing. In fact, he'd give you therapy on how to do the same thing. So suppress how you really feel, because it is a choice and you could live a straight lifestyle, and if you don't, you're guilty.
I think that this will be used as propaganda by conservatives, but considering the fact that it aired on VH1, which is not an anti-gay network, and they don't have that type of agenda, I don't think that that's what their point was. I think their point was, hey, this is really interesting. It's going to get us good ratings. Let's talk about his story. I don't think that they intend to use it as propaganda, but I do agree that conservatives will use it as propaganda, so that's dangerous.
I don't want to...
Look, I'm not putting intentions on VH1. The flip side is I'd be really surprised if it wasn't pitched in some way by the Mormon Church.
I just don't want this guy seeing other people in a clinical environment. Like, go run a hardware store. Go do literally do anything else.